Hello school, it's Reverend Colin here and it's lovely to be with you for another assembly. Now this morning I'd like to tell you about somebody who was very courageous, who did something very brave and stood up for doing it because they believed what they were doing was right. Now this is a person who lived quite a long time ago. You might have heard of her. You might know something about her. Here's a picture of this lady. I wonder if you know who that lady is. You can tell from her clothes that she lived a long time ago. Do you know her name? This lady is called Florence Nightingale. And she was very famous person over 100 years ago. Let me tell you about her. Florence was born in quite a wealthy family. They had lots of money, they had big houses, they had servants, they went on big holidays, they travelled all over Europe. But Florence knew that most people didn't live like that. That most people didn't have that kind of money, that in fact they were very poor. Florence wanted to help, and when she was 24, she decided that she wanted to become a nurse, that she wanted to help people who weren't as fortunate as her and help them out of their problems. So she decided she would become a nurse. And she would go and care for sick people. Because nursing is a very worthwhile career. I wonder, do any of you want to be a nurse or a doctor when you get older? How many of you would like to care for people? I can't see you, but if you can, if you do, perhaps you can talk about it later. But Florence's plans didn't go down well with her family. In fact, her parents were horrified. A well-to-do young woman who wanted to go and give up her life to do that. Why wouldn't she want to marry some rich man and go and live in a big house and have fancy parties and nice dresses and all those lovely things that money can bring? Her mother just wanted her to live a normal life. But Florence knew that God wanted her to do something different. And so, against her parents' wishes, against what her mum and dad wanted, she went and became a doctor. Florence's mother and sister were so upset, so horrified, that they actually stopped talking to her. How do you think that made Florence feel? How do you think she would have felt when her mum and her sister said, "We don't want anything to do with you"? We should all respect our parents. We should all do what they ask us to do. But you know, sometimes when we get older, when we become grown-ups, we might disagree and we might feel very strongly about something. And sometimes we have to have the courage, like Florence had the courage, to say, "I'm going to go a different way." You know, today we're very fortunate with our hospitals. They're lovely, clean places where people go in and they get better and they get treated. But in Florence's day, it wasn't the same. Now, Florence was a very, very clever woman, actually. She was good at maths. She was good at languages. She could speak Latin and Greek and French and Italian and all sorts of different languages. She was good at writing. When she became a nurse, she realised that not everybody got better the way they should. And she used her maths to show what was going on. I wonder, have any of you ever drawn a pie chart? Have you ever drawn a pie chart? If you don't know what one is, it's a chart like this that shows different values? Well, it might interest you to know that Florence Nightingale invented pie charts. This woman was so clever, she invented this way of showing information. So when you draw a pie chart, remember Florence. During Florence's time as a nurse, a war happened a long way away in Turkey in a place called Crimea. And the British soldiers were fighting out there in terrible conditions, and many were getting wounded and going to hospital. And Florence decided that's where she should be. But it wasn't easy, because women weren't expected to go out to places where there was wars. They weren't wanted on the battlefield, even as nurses. But she was determined, and again she had the courage. She had the courage to go and help. She felt God telling her, that's where you should be. And so she went. And when she got there, she found terrible conditions. She realised that more soldiers were dying of illness and disease than they were from battle. There were more illnesses around than wounds. And so she set about making things better. And at night, she would wander around the wards carrying a lamp. And she would have a candle in or walk around the wards and make the soldiers feel better, make them feel that somebody cared. And her nickname became the Lady with the Lamp. Florence Nightingale was known as the Lady with the Lamp. Through her work, many, many soldiers' lives were changed and saved, and they got better, when before she was there, they wouldn't have. And when she came home to England after the war, she campaigned. She campaigned against people who didn't want to have changes to make sure that hospitals became cleaner, that treatment became better, and that people didn't die of illnesses and infections like they were in the Crimea. She did what she felt was right. She stood up against the people who were against her, who didn't want her to do these things. She became very, very famous, so famous that her picture was put on the £10 note. It's not there anymore. This is a picture of an old £10 note. And you can see the picture of Florence, but can you see next to her? There she is with her lamp, walking through the ward of the hospital at night, bringing comfort to the soldiers. We remember Florence because she did some amazing things. We remember Florence because she helped those soldiers. She helped to make hospitals better places. She helped to make nursing better. Without courage, without standing up against those who said, you're wrong, or you shouldn't be doing this, none of that would have happened. Sometimes we have to look inside ourselves. We have to look inside ourselves for the strength and the courage to do what we think's right when other people think what we're doing is wrong. Some people, like Florence, turned to God for strength in those times. She prayed to God that God would give her the courage in big things and in small things. And God did. And Florence made a huge difference. So when you're afraid, when you think, I haven't got the courage to do this thing, when you want to stand up against someone who says you're wrong, remember Florence. Remember Florence Nightingale. Remember this lady and her courage and all she did. Let's pray. If you'd like to pray, close your eyes and be quiet. If you don't want to pray with me, that's fine. Just sit quietly and think about what I've said. Let's pray. Dear God, we thank you for the life of Florence Nightingale. We thank you for her courage and her perseverance We thank you that she fought for what she knew to be right and good. Give us the courage to do what is right and good. Amen. Thank you, everybody. Thank you for listening, and I will be with you soon. Bye-bye.